He's known as the Mad Stork. 15 seasons in the National Football League, 8 Pro Bowls, played in 4 Super Bowls. The legendary Hall of Famer, 1990, Ted Hendricks.
Our defensive lineman, who was a nose guard, he was the mad dog, and he gave everybody a nickname with mad in front of it on the defensive team. And I had real skinny legs, and I looked like the mascot that the Hurricanes had, which was the Ibis, and that's in the Stork family, so he called me the Mad Stork. And we had one guy with an oversized head, he was the Mad Head. And we had one defensive back, his last name was Guy, and he was the Mad Fly, because he could really zip around back there. And all of our defensive team was given a nickname with Mad in front of it.
Ted, you had a chance to play in 4 Super Bowls, 3 with the Raiders. Talk about, give me one of your fondest memories that come right to mind right now when you think of the Silver and Black.
First of all, you know the Raiders have never lost a game.
Yeah!
They were way out of time.
That's what I'm talking about.
We go upon that premise. And, most of the Super Bowls that I had with the Raiders, they were over with it in the third period. And the one I remember probably the most is the Washington game.
Oh, yeah.
I had two muscles in my stomach and two pulled muscles in my groin. And I was glad that Marcus Allen made that run, because then I could sit down and watch the game. That was a fantastic game that we pulled off.
Yeah.
Lester Hayes and Mike Haynes shut him down on receiving. Shut the run game off, and Riggins couldn't get anything. So that was a real fantastic game.
My question is to Ted. Ted, in the Super Bowl Sports Illustrated, there's a picture of you blocking Tony Franklin's kick in the second quarter versus the Eagles in the Super Bowl. Maybe you could tell us about that play, what you remember, or what adjustments the Raiders made for that game, because during the regular season, the Raiders lost 10-7 at Veterans Stadium, and then you defeated the Eagles in the Super Bowl.
The thing about it is that we used to study the films and find the weakest linemen in the three of them, the center and the two guards. And then we get a power rush, three guys on that one guy, and get a power rush in there, and then hold our hands up, and hopefully one of us will block it. We got to rush so deep into the line one game that Matt Millen even blocked a kick. And he's only 5'11". So it was just one of those things that that kept them from scoring going into halftime, and then we took care of them the rest of the game. And Rod Martin should have been named the player of the game, because he had 3 interceptions.
Yeah.